Hi everyone, thank you for joining in. I would like to present you my long-term short review of the Zoom H2n field audio recorder / multipurpose USB microphone. So without further ado, let's start from unboxing. My device came in quite simple and more or less environment-friendly packaging, which is quite easy to recycle. Batteries and SD card were not included, just as stated on the box. Inside, besides Zoom H2n itself, we've got a thick pack of paper-printed manuals and safety instructions. As you can see, everything is very nicely explained. Of course, it would be just a right thing to read or at least to look through the pictures before you start using it for the first time. Now let's take a look at the recorder itself. It is indeed a very small device. It's made out of quite hard and shiny plastic, with metal mesh cup around the microphones, which takes up around 40% of the surface of the device. Feels light, but very well built. On front, it has a big display and specially shaped, quite convenient record button. On the left side of the device, we've got 3.5mm line-in, volume up-down buttons, 3.5mm line-out, remote control connector, last but not least, USB mini-B connection for power and data transfer. On the right side, it has recording volume knob, on-off hold switch, home button and play pause up down lever. On the top it has a microphone mode switch. On the opposite side it has standard SD card slot and mounting hole for use with a tripod. On the back side it has plastic door for batteries department. Let's install pair of batteries and SD card. Pulling on off hold lever down wakes it up and in several seconds H2n is ready to use. Have to say that this recorder is very simple to use. One press on the menu button and we are in the menu settings. Menu itself is very easy to operate. As you can see right here, there is a lot of functionality and one can change everything very easy just with one hand, which is quite comfortable from my own personal experience. H2n has an MS plus XY, so-called double configuration, which consists of the array of 5 microphones, whereas all microphones can be used together or separated in different modes for mono, stereo, spatial or surround sound recording. As you can see, operating on the fly is an easy thing here. One can adjust stereo mode on MS capsule just with one hand. H2n also can be used as an I/O interface for almost any computing device. Here I've got an iPad Pro. As soon as it connected, it got instantaneously recognized by the iPad OS. H2n can be used as the interface or SD card reader. Speaking of transfer speed, for modern day standards, it is quite slow, but it is very convenient and usable. Zoom H2n works very well as 2-in, 2-out interface. One can record and monitor audio at the same time. In this mode, H2n will be limited to 16-bit only. I would recommend to use H2n with the tripod. It has a very common mounting connector. One can use almost any standard configuration with it. It comes quite handy if you would want to use H2n as an interview microphone, or, as in this particular case, H2n makes it possible to record surround sound, spatial audio, for the business meetings or any roundtable conversations. H2n also can be used as a voice recorder or dictaphone, as some call it. It has an auto-on function, whereas it could be activated automatically in presence of the audio signal of certain user programmable volume level. It is also possible to edit and re-export recorded files right on the device without using the computer. Another very important feature, in my opinion, is the presence of the 3.5mm input jack. I use H2n quite often as a lavalier microphone recorder. Mono stream comes in on channel 1 or left, but you can mix it down as mono so it could be possible to work with the recordings in, so to say, usual way. As you can see, in case with a stereo lavalier microphone, situation is even easier. H2n is a perfect companion for video. It is small, versatile and easy to use. One can record stereo or mix down to stereo or spatial or surround audio just right to the camera through the headphones line out 3.5mm jack. Recordings I've made with H2n were very good, with good dynamic and very low noise. H2n makes possible to record raw MS audio, whereas output of both microphones recorded on separate channel for further manipulation in software or DAW. One can download special MS Decoder plugin from the Zoom Corp website. It is very easy to work with. Please take a look. As example, I use Cubase Element Session. Here I've got both microphones recorded in surround mode, whereas MS microphones recording is in raw format, and XY just a normal stereo, all in 24-bit. As you can see here, in the channel strip, I've got Zoom 64-bit MS plugin up and running. As I already said, it is very easy to use. You have to find suitable mono stereo balance for the recording. One can also mix it down as full mono and then implement it in the mix for center or front height surround channel in the post-production. The possibilities here is seriously extended. Besides recording from the built-in microphones, H2n is nearly perfect companion for any music session, whereas it can be used as a two-channel 24-bit 96 kHz audio recorder. One can record Ableton, GarageBand or NI Traktor sessions right through the 3.5mm aux input jack. I have to say again that all recordings I made with it were sound very clean, with good dynamic and very low noise. After any recording, just connect it through the data connector and transfer files to the PC. It is very convenient and easy to do. Zoom also offers a very nice line of accessories for H2n, including special pack, but I personally prefer collect it all according to my own preference. Happily, H2n does not require any special accessories. Everything is quite standard, so to say, easily available online. I purchased all of that over a year of using H2n. It's a nice opportunity to choose the best accessories according to my own personal preference and needs. Now I would like to present you a couple of fragments of audio recordings I've made recently with H2n here in the neighborhood in The Hague. Zoom H2n is a very interesting device. I'm using it more often than Zoom H6, although H6 is a much better recorder overall. Recording quality on H2n is just good enough for professional use. I'm using H2n for recording of ambient sound on the fly, and of course recording of audio for video. I admire convenience of the size of this device. Array of 5 microphones makes it possible to implement it quite widely in many applications as a standalone recorder or part of the rig. Presence of MS capsule makes it possible to use it as a mono microphone for interviews as well. The ability to perform simple edit of the recording right on the device is also very convenient. Speaking of battery life, I can confirm that 2 fully charged Analog Pro AA size batteries is enough for over 20 hours of stereo recording in 24-bit 96 kHz. And that would be all for now. Thank you for joining in. Thumbs up if you liked it. Please subscribe and see you all next time.